And Poncho Man! We are brought to you by ES Myoplex, Hoka One One, Polar Velo Fix, Normatec, Four Seasons, Hualalai, Amio, Power Breather. All of our guests today are getting a gift certificate from Velo Fix. Our guests, 1982 Ironman World Champion Kathleen McCartney, and one of our favorite people on the planet, Mr. Mike Levine. How are you guys doing? These things are called microphones. You can pick those up. Yeah.
Okay. It's so great to be here, Bob, and to be here in Kona once again. And we're just so looking forward to the whole race week and race day.
With a big purpose. So Mike watched Kathleen do the February 82 Ironman and decided he was going to get into this stuff. Comes in October of 82 and 83.
Right.
Did probably, over 100 triathlons your career?
Over 100 triathlons, marathons throughout my career, on and off throughout the years. But Kath was my inspiration, as she was to thousands of other people, to get into this incredible sport we have.
So then July 2015, you're diagnosed with stage 4 pancreatic cancer.
Correct, right.
And basically 6 to 9 months to live.
It was like a lightning bolt just came out of nowhere.
Get your affairs in order, make sure your will is done.
Yep.
Your life, as you know it, is basically over.
Yeah, I was steak. I was history.
And how did you react? How did you and your lovely wife, Jan?
I think for probably first three or four days, we just sat around the house just not living it. You can't absorb something like that.
Right.
And then slowly reality comes in. You start talking with the doctors, and you start reading all the data and the facts, and you just deal with it. None of us are going to be here forever, but you just try to get the best care you can.
Sure.
And go forward.
And then you're going through chemo. You're going through all the standard stuff. You
horrible,
have the Whipple surgery. Explain that.
Yeah, there's a surgery. Pancreatic cancer, a lot of people might not be familiar with. It's a tiny little organ, the pancreas, that's between the spine and the stomach. And it's probably the deadliest of all the cancers. And the main reason is usually not discovered until you're late stage 4. Symptoms develop, and then oftentimes people are gone within 30 to 60 days. So at any rate, it's just I discovered it. I had some side effects that didn't seem right. Discolored urine, as if you were dehydrated. Working out, but that wasn't my case. And so after a few days, I went in, saw the doctor, and did some tests, and things started showing.
And in the Whipple surgery, they cut out pieces of what, six organs?
Well, the Whipple surgery, what they want to do is get a wide margin around the cancer or the tumor itself, so they remove six organs from me. And the Whipple procedure, what they do is they remove the half the pancreas, part of the stomach, part of the intestine, take out the bile ducts, the duodenum, and the jejunum. From a medical standpoint, I can't exactly tell you what that is, but then they just replumb you together, and you just go on about your business. It's a rough surgery.
It was a
2-week stay in the hospital.
And I ran into Jan at the airport, and she told me what was going on, and we started corresponding. And then Jan, and I think it was around Thanksgiving last year, said, "Hey, you know what? We're probably moving up to Northwest. We're probably I'm going to need help taking care of Mike as he spirals downward." And can you put together a group of folks to come over from the 80s? So we had, for a barbecue, we had John Howard and Kenny Souza and Julie Moss, and Kathleen was sick and couldn't make it.
Right.
But then Kathleen reached out and said, "Hey, how about a bike ride?" When she said that, what did you think?
I was like, I had never met Kath. She, again, was my original inspiration for getting into the sport, as she was to thousands of others. And I was a little intimidated because I was pretty weak state after everything I'd gone through. So I said, sure, why not? So we coordinated it and did our first bike ride. It was after the holidays, early January.
And it was about how long did you guys ride, Kath?
Oh, gosh, we rode for about an hour, but we had to stop every few miles for Mike to catch his breath. I mean, Mike had been spending time just kind of on the couch, kind of giving up on life.
Right.
So for him to even get off the couch and come outside was a big deal.
And when you saw the state he was in, at that point, you're not thinking, I got an idea, let's go to Kona.
Right. No, not at all. In fact, I met him and his wife, Jan, for the first time. This was on January 18th of this year.
Yeah.
And we met for this bike ride, and I wasn't sure how he was going to like it and if you'd ever want to do it again.
Right.
And at the end of this ride, even though it was difficult for Mike because his lungs were still so compromised and he's on chemo for life, there's a spark in him that kind of came out of this great ride together, And I asked him to come out again and would do it again next week. So we started meeting every week for these bike rides.
And in the meantime, you get a new doctor, Dr. Fanta from UCSD, I think.
Right.
And he's like, listen, you guys, quit planning your funeral. Quit making a list of things you need to put together. Go on a cruise. Go live your life.
He did. Yeah, he said, look, let me take care of the cancer, and you guys go on a cruise. Have faith in me. I think we can get things turned around. We saw this new doctor because the cancer had spread to both my lungs. I couldn't breathe. I was coughing 24 hours a day. I mean, you would look at the MRI, CAT scans, and my lungs were completely white with cancer cells. And but sure enough, within 8 or 9 weeks, he reversed it, and I could start breathing again. So that's the beauty of it. And going back, or just after, when Kathleen came into my life, the inspiration, the power of that inspiration was amazing. Between what the new doctor was doing for me and Kathleen, my cancer has been knocked way down, and here I am in Kona.
Well, the lungs cleared up, and Kathleen, you would ride to Mike's cancer treatments and be there with him.
Yes.
And then you would ride home the next day, you guys do brick workouts.
Right. Well, we became close friends, Mike, Jan, and I.
Yes.
Because when you meet Mike and Jan, they're some of the nicest people you could ever meet, and they were very open about Mike's cancer and
right.
what they'd gone through. And so when you connect so deeply with someone, it's easy to establish a friendship and trust.
And also, this sport has been part of your life since forever, right?
Right.
Early 80s.
Yeah, this sport has been a part of my life since 1981 when I came here to Kona just to watch Ironman for the first time. And I was so inspired when I watched the race that I decided I wanted to come back and do it again the following year. So I did my first Ironman in 82.
And that was the classic race where
yes.
Julie Moss was leading. You passed her to finish, and that was the race that really put the sport on the map.
Yes.
ABC was covering it that day, and the phone lines lit up as Julie crawled across the finish line. Nobody knew if she was alive or dead. The two of you end up getting on a ABC, bringing yeah. you to New York
yes.
To be with Jim McKay. To
yes.
basically assure the American public that you weren't dead.
Yeah.
right? That Julie was not dead. And from there, they added a second Ironman that year in October,
right.
which Mike did.
Right.
Yes.
And the United States Triathlon Series started in June.
Yes.
And the sport just took off.
Yeah,
it changed everything. Your moment
right.
changed. We can talk about people winning the race and champions, but that race touched a nerve. People
yes.
saw what Julie would do to get to that finish line.
Right.
And you guys actually came back here 30 years later
right.
to race again.
Yes.
And so for you to be part of this journey with Mike, this is a very selfish sport, but for you to be part of something that's way bigger than
yes.
any of us,
yes.
how important has this been to you?
Now, I have to say, you know, just being here at Ironman for the last 35 years as a competitor, on and off throughout my life, I've come back here at times that were very difficult for me, and turning back to Ironman and the Ironman community as a source of strength.
Right.
And every experience with Ironman is transformational. The training and the race day, there you grow from it. But this particular experience this year, I never could have imagined that I would be on this Ironman journey with Mike and Jan. And I feel like this is the most meaningful thing that I've ever experienced in my life. To hear someone tell you that you've breathed the life back into them. That is what I hear from Mike.
That's what you did.
That is the most powerful honor that I could ever receive, and I'm so committed to that. So I'm thrilled to be here with Mike and go through another transformation, and not just for Mike, but you know, for all
anybody else,
for anyone else
who's been
watching.
Gotten that same diagnosis
yes.
and has been told that your life is over.
Exactly.
Mike is a living, breathing example that you never give up.
That's right.
And what I love is you called after, I don't know, it was like a month or two, or you called and said, I think Mike can do Kona.
Yeah.
This is after I saw Mike on that first ride.
I know.
Standing
right.
on the side of the road.
Yeah.
And I'm like, wait, he can do what? Like, go fly to Kona and watch you race? Yeah, sure, he could do that.
Right.
He could race Kona.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so basically, based on your word, I called the NBC guys and
yeah.
said, Kathleen,
yeah.
Kathleen doesn't, she knows what it takes
yeah.
to get that finish
yeah.
line. She thinks Mike can do it. They're like, Ironman was all in. And then we surprised you on June 29th. What were your thoughts when all of a sudden, Kathleen, you handed you that race number to the 2017 Ironman World Championship?
I was as stunned as I was when I got my cancer diagnosis. Although this
but
was
a good
this
way.
Was a much better diagnosis, yeah. So, yeah, it was fabulous. And rest is history. Here we are.
I love that.
We have to keep pinching ourselves. Like, every time I see Mike, I just say, Mike, we're going to Kona. And, you know, it's such a dream to be here and to have this as a goal, because it has brought Mike back to life.
No question.
I saw him ride a few miles, and he was exhausted, and he was depleted. And then just to see him come alive and get fit and go out on 80-mile bike rides and do, you know, 15 to 20-hour training weeks, it's just it's actually miraculous and hard to even imagine what hope does and what the sport of triathlon and what Ironman does to bring you purpose and power in your life.
And when you know you get off the plane coming to this and even before that, Alaska Airlines. Big, obviously, Jan works for Alaska.
All right.
And what did they have set up for you when you got to the airport?
Oh, it was amazing. We walked in yesterday, and everybody at the ticket counter had Go Mike t-shirts on Alaska Airlines.
Yeah, it was great.
And the TSA were real friendly for change, you know, greeting us and say,
and,
Go Mike.
And they had a cake.
Even though they took my cartridges from me, you know, for my tires.
They weren't that friendly.
Yeah.
They didn't take mine, though.
But, no, inside at the gate, they had a nice big cake set up for us and refreshments, beverages. Balloons and some gifts, and it was just fantastic. You know, great send off.
Is a goal to try to stay together most of the day?
Oh, yeah, yeah. From the very beginning, we've wanted to do this side by side as much as you can at Ironman. We obviously can't swim together.
Right.
We can't ride next to each other, but we will be, you know, six bike lengths apart. And it's funny because we have developed this communication on the road, and it's like we have this unspoken communication, because when we're out training, we try to keep a distance apart to get him prepared for the fact he's not going to be drafting, so we don't draft in training. So I'm like pointing, I'm turning my neck, I'm checking at him, and I'm like, my gosh, we're going to have to throw in a little bit more of that in Kona, because we kind of know what each other's saying now, just by kind of like pointing and turning and glances and everything. It's kind of funny.
Yeah, I'd like to add, she's one tough drill instructor too. She comes up and she looks at my water bottles and says, "You hydrating? Drink." Yeah.
How cool has this journey been for you, and just being back here in Kona? It's been years since you've been here, right?
It's been, besides vacations, it's been years. I mean, when you think about the last time I did a race here, 83 Ironman, that was over a third of a century ago. And I still feel every inch and every ounce of pain from that race.
What do you guys think it's going to feel like coming down Elite Drive, knowing this journey? And not just this journey for you two, but for all the people, not just pancreatic cancer, but anything else where they've been told your life is over, that you better start making plans, you better start planning out your will, because nothing good is going to happen from here on out.
Yeah, you know, life is short, and I say, as far as if you want to make any plans, plan for the best and plan for hope. Just fight and give everything you can to survive. Life's too precious, and my word to everybody out there with who's got a challenge health situation, whether it be cancer or anything, is just fight. You know, become a soldier for the cause. If you can help raise funds through your community for whatever foundation or organizations precious to you, please do. But the main thing is just live your passions, live your dreams, and you know, fight all the way.
I think we're going to have a lot of Mike Levine fans out there on Saturday cheering you guys out.
Yeah.
Thanks so much, you guys, for coming in. Thanks, and Bob. This woman's been a little bit of an angel, huh?
She has. She's actually adopted family now. So, she's like my little sister. Yeah.
Love that. How about a round of applause for Mike Levine? Kathleen McCartney, Poncho Man, take us out.
Walk of jelly, breakfast with Bob.
Poncho Man, thank you. Yeah.